He cheats on my mom all the time. I have proof my mom knows, and she wasn't surprised when I told her before they got married. People told my mom not to marry him, but she did, and I feel bad because she has put up with a lot from him and my sister. Listen, that sucks. But when it comes to adult affairs, that is none of your business. And this is my channel, and today we will be doing a The Mafia Speak session where you guys send in your stories, I read them on camera, I give my advice, and The Mafia gives you advice down below. If you guys ever want some advice, send everything to themafiaspeaks@gmail.com. I know I haven't done a spectacular job with these in terms of answering them. However, trust me, I'll be doing them 10 times more often because I really want to get into engaging with you guys. And since I'm posting Monday through Friday this entire month of November, I wanted to really get to the nitty gritty of things. Please make sure you guys do not send anything to my business email. Trust me, it will automatically get deleted because I don't play that shit with my business email. Also, if you guys ever want any YouTube advice, if you guys want anything regarding YouTube tips, you guys are free to join the free Facebook group. Keep an eye, you have to answer all the questions in order to be automatically admitted or have me manually do it. If not, your shit will sit in the request, but you can easily just follow the Instagram, the Facebook, or the Twitter because I post tips there all the time, and I do free webinars once a month. For my first one, I did how to get more views and subscribers on YouTube, and then for my second one, I did how to pick your niche on YouTube. Every time I do these webinars, I put them in the Facebook group, and you guys can watch them that way. Also, if you haven't gotten your merch, get your merch and join the Mafia group chat on Throne. Super lit, $5 a month. We popping in there. Hey, first I want to say you are so pretty and you and your boyfriend are the cutest. Thank you. Why y'all so nice to me? Hope y'all having a great day or evening. This is the 26th. Had a great evening. I'm sorry, y'all. Well, I've been going through it and I don't know where to start. My dad is toxic, a cheater, and lies a lot. Messy always in people's business, always talking about people behind their backs, and it's sad. Sounds like most people. He cheats on my mom all the time. I have proof my mom knows, and she wasn't surprised when I told her before they got married. People told my mom not to marry him, but she did, and I feel bad because she has put up with a lot from him and my sister. Listen, that sucks. But when it comes to adult affairs, that is none of your business. Now, I'm not saying, like, you know, you shouldn't be concerned, but it comes to a point where, like, especially with adults, I've learned something recently. I read a couple articles on, like, opinions and, like, changing adults' minds. Apparently, it's, like, almost virtually impossible to change an adult's mind. If the person is, like, over the age of, like, 25, even, like, I would say maybe 30, but I saw, like, 25, 26, it's really going to be impossible because that person is already set in their ways, set in their beliefs, and set in their bullshit at that point. So if she knew he was cheating and she still married him, she's probably going to keep allowing this to happen. It's a very slim chance that she's going to come out of it. It does suck, and no one's saying you have to, like, be happy about it or, like, not say anything. Trust me, that's not what I'm saying. But I'm saying she probably ain't going to listen to you, girl. And if that's what she want to fucking do, that's her fucking business. Like, I ain't got time. Like, my parents have done a lot of shit that I just be like, bro, like, are you dumb? Also, I've had a lot of friends that are, like, older than me that do a lot of shit, and I'm like, bro, are you dumb? But it's come to a point where it's like, I'm not about to sit here and coddle you and baby you and try to tell you if something's wrong when you know it's wrong already. Because they know it's wrong. They know it's not okay. 99.9999% of the time, people who are going through things like this, people who are getting cheated on, people who are being abused, people who are being mistreated know it. They're just not going to do anything about it. Because at the end of the day, for them, it's more of a situation where it's like, I'm already in this situation, so what can I do about it? Or I love this person and I'm willing to look past it. Or it can be worse. Or, like, there's so many reasons why people put up with this type of shit, to be honest. My sister and dad's relationship is not the best because my dad is toxic and narcissist, and my sister is also, I feel as though, toxic. Me and her don't have the best relationship either. I love these people, I truly do, but I don't know if I can do it with them anymore. My mom's mental health is terrible from getting cheated on and getting talked down on and having low self-esteem and not knowing what and not oh and not knowing what Okay, I think you meant to say not knowing her worth. Okay, makes her mental health go downhill. She's not the same no more. She's been in and out of the hospital. She's at the hospital now, but staying in the psych ward for that long, seeing her in that manner was very traumatizing for me and honestly hard to think about and gets me emotional. She can't leave because she's staying for me and my little sister, which I get, but it's like, why risk her happiness for children or church? I personally, if I ever was married, we're going through a relationship, would never expect cheating or disrespect, but my mom is blind, I guess. You could say love is blind and she needs to elevate and find. What do you think love is truly not? Okay. Before I go on, my mom went through something very similar. I'm not even about to put her business out there, but my dad wasn't the best. I still love my dad and definitely, trust me right now, they are in a better place, but my mom never ended up in a psych ward because of all of the mess. I don't know what I would do if that were to happen. And me and my dad have a very good relationship. Like, he's in Haiti right now and I'm mad anxious about it. Like, sometimes I can't even sleep. I can't even think straight because I'm like, oh my God, how about something happens to him? Because he's like diabetic. His diabetes is pretty bad. So it's like, I have a really close relationship with my dad. I don't hate my mom, but I just started getting close with my mom as, like, you know, high school into college type shit. So it's like, I've always been close to my dad since I was like fucking born. So it's like, I know he was shitty to my mom and I know my mom went through a lot of shit because of him, but I'm also about holding people accountable. And I believe that my mom and my dad should have got a divorce. I always say that all the time and they'd be so upset. Like, why would you say that? I'm like, honestly, y'all should have got a divorce. Like, I would have been fine. I don't understand the logic of people staying in relationships for kids, but I do understand it. I don't believe in divorce and I don't believe in people having kids out of wedlock. However, I don't believe in people putting themselves in horrible situations. If you are being abused, if you're being disrespected, abort mission, okay? Abort the baby, abort the relationship, abort all of it. For the simple fact that I believe your mental health is very, very important. And I feel like, especially, I don't know if you're foreign or not, but a lot of foreigners tend to do this. Comment down below if you have parents that do this. Miserable as hell, sleeping in different rooms, like genuinely, like not even speaking to each other, but they're together for the kids. People need to understand, if you happen to be a parent and you're watching this and you're doing something like this, this actually hurts your kid more than getting a divorce, for the simple fact that they can tell. Unless you guys are really gonna pretend for real, like this whole we're in the same house though does not help. Your kids are not stupid. I'm tired of people thinking kids are dumb. Like, you would be surprised the shit I remember when I was like 3. Okay, and I'm 25 now. Your kids are not dumb. They sense tension. They sense animosity. They sense unhappiness. They hear the tone in your voice. They see y'all sleeping in different rooms. They see y'all cheating on each other. They see it. Your kids are not stupid. And a divorce will hurt. But two happy parents coexisting together in their separate lives to take care of one child with a common goal of making their children happy is better than two bitter parents living in the same house taking out their anger out on their kids and on themselves and their kids sitting there watching their, you know, parents deteriorate. I realistically don't like the idea of getting a divorce, but I feel like when it starts fucking with your mental health and it starts messing with your well-being, it's time to cut it quits. You know, it's time to let it go. It's time to call it quits. It's time to let go. Because at the end of the day, it's not going to help you. It's not going to help the kids if you are not at your best. If you're going through mental health issues and you refuse to get help, that means you're not at your best. That means you are not going to be at your best for anyone else in your life. And this goes for everyone watching this. If you know you are mentally unstable, if you know you are not at your best mentally, go get some help. Because if you are not your best self, you are not of use to a soul. I'm telling you this right now. It will get worse. And the more you ignore it, the worse it will get. Like I said, I don't know what I would have done if my mom would have ended up in a psych ward because of my dad. At that point, me and him would have definitely had some fucking problems. But my dad has definitely done a lot of fuck shit. He ain't perfect. But then again, my mom ain't perfect either, to be honest. But it's just like, honestly, I just believe that people should choose happiness first. Like, I believe you should at least try to save your marriage. And I think that's the problem. I feel like a lot of people don't really try to save their marriages. I feel like a lot of people just step out of the relationship or they just give up really too easily. And it's like, oh, wow, this relationship is done. And it's like, but did you even fucking try? So that's what I mean when I'm like, nigga, like, stick it out. But at the same time, it's like, if it comes to the point where you guys have both tried, you put your all into it and it's just not working. My mom has been through so much and I hate to see her in pain. It makes me cry. And when she vents to me, I tend to get emotional because I just don't know what to say or do. And all of this has made my mental health get worse, but I'm praying and planning another therapist session. It's very rare that anyone writes to me and they say that they're getting psychological help. A lot of times they're like, oh, I'm trying to stick it out, or oh, I don't feel like going to therapy, or oh, my parents won't let me. Thank you for seeking the help that you need and knowing that you have a problem. Definitely advise, and I had to tell this to my mom and it hurt. It really hurt. But this wasn't even in regards to my dad. It was just because, like, she had lost her job when I first started college. She was very, very upset about it. Like, my mom's a workaholic. And my mom had been working at that job for over 20 years. So when she got fired, like, that shit fucked her up. But it was my first year of college. I didn't know how I was going to pay college. And she's sitting here overwhelming me with her issues. And I told her, like, yo, please stop telling me about this stuff because it's not good for me. Like, I do not feel good. She stopped. And it hurt. And she told me straight up, like, you know, you're the only one that I can talk to. And I was like, yo, I get you, but this is not the time. Like, I have to get my shit together unless you want me to be like you. That sounds harsh, but it's true. Like, I just remembered that. That was a very sad moment because I really had to tell her, like, yo, like, dead ass. Like, I can't. Like, you're really, like, this is hurting me to hear that you're hurt. And it's stopping me from being able to do what I need to do. Woo! I might just cry. Like, it... That sucks, especially when you develop a bond with your parents where it's like they know they can come to you. I don't think people understand, and it's not even just a parent thing. There's certain people that you care about so much that when they cry, you cry. If something hurts them, it hurts you, and it starts to fuck with you. And you do want to be there, but you're not a professional, and it's going to fuck with you. So now y'all both going to be suffering, and who you going to talk to? You know, because at that point you can't talk to that person because it's like, I don't want to impose my problems on you because your problems seem worse than mine. So learn when to say enough is enough and learn when to protect your energy. That's something I really had to learn the hard way. I've always been someone that would like absorb everyone's problems. Like, I was the type of person who would sit there and like try to be Captain Save-A-Ho when it came to people's issues, always giving advice, always trying to be there, always pulling up to people when they needed me. And then I realized, like, this is not healthy. Like, I do not feel good. I feel horrible. Like, it got to the point where, like, I was, like, sick all the time. And it was because of all of this ridiculous energy bouncing off of me from other people's problems. Like, you really have to protect your energy. It's either you or her. And honestly, she's your mom, and she would definitely understand. And I'm not saying, like, cut her off and don't listen to her. I'm saying, like, tell her at least if she could keep it at a minimum, or like try to keep certain things at bay, or wait till you're in a better mental state to handle whatever it is that she's going through. For anyone going through that, trust me, your parents actually truly care about you. And if you just tell them like, hey, you're stressing me out, they're most likely going to listen. It may seem like they won't, but I've seen it happen. I've told my friends to do the same thing and it actually does work. So just try it. Regarding my sister, she says, my mom did bad things to her and I feel like she's not telling the truth. I was venting to my sister about how I've been feeling and this is what she said. I show you the pictures. There is so much I want to say, but I'm emotional. Ugh, life of a Pisces. Anyways, hope you're doing good. As far as your sister saying that your mom has done things to her, I'm not one to invalidate people's feelings, but I am one to acknowledge that people do be lying. I've had friends lie about having cancer, friends lie about being raped, friends lie about all types of crazy shit. Guys, you'd be surprised what people lie about. But even if I think someone's lying, I would never invalidate them to their face. I would just nod and listen and keep that shit to myself. Like, I don't think she's telling the truth, or that man is lying. But I would never invalidate someone's feelings because I feel like that would be a very horrible feeling to like tell someone something happened and they not believe you. Also, I've realized that a lot of things are very perception based. Like, what I may think is one thing, you may think is something else. Like, there's been people that I can tell you played the hell out of me, and you'd be like, he did not play you, girl. You was just dumb. Probably, but I saw it as me being played, so I've been played. There's been situations where people have come to me, and they're like, oh, well, it's mad fake, and she did this, she did that, so I don't fuck with her. And it's like, honestly, I don't think she did anything wrong. So it's one of those things where it's like, some things are very, very subjective, and you may perceive something differently than she does. Also, I also think that when it comes to stuff like that, that's something you keep between them. Like, do not get involved. Like, for example, my sister and my dad don't have the best relationship and they didn't talk for years. I did a video, sit down with her. You guys can check it out. I might leave it in the eye. If not, it's in my most recent videos, or I'll link it down below. And it's crazy because, like, she will sit there and be like, oh, he wasn't in my life, dot, dot, dot. And I'm like, I remember us always being together. Like, but I'm not about to sit there and invalidate her feelings because I live with the dude, you feel me? So I can't sit there and be like, that bitch lying, she doing too much. If that's how she perceived it, that's what's affecting her. And if that's what she believes, I'm not gonna say it's true. But that's her experience. And no one can take your experience away from you. If you genuinely feel that way, it may not be true, but that's your experience and you need to work through it by either confronting the person, coming to terms with that, or literally just, I guess, forgetting it all together. Because I'm not about to sit there and be like, no, you didn't, no, he didn't, no. Like, I can't. I don't defend anyone's actions anymore because the shit that I've done defended, I done stood up for, and then later on found out was true or not true or whatever. It's like, I just be like, damn, that's crazy. I resignate. Damn, that's fucked up. Do you want help? Do you want therapy? Do you want my support? Do you want a hug? Do you want to sleep over? That's all I can do. I'm not about to invalidate anyone's feelings. So I would suggest you just let that be that. Let her situation with your mom be the situation with your mom. Who knows? Maybe the mom did abuse her. Because you know there are situations where people will treat certain kids better than another kid. I've had situations, or I've had friends where their mom would starve them. Meanwhile, the other kids are like living like they live in Bel Air. Kid you not seen this. I've seen situations where certain kids will get beat while the other ones won't. And they all live in the same household. You feel me? So I do believe certain people can treat all of their kids differently and hold their kids to different standards. Comment down below, what would you do if you were in this girl's situation? Let me know what you think about this video down in the comment section below. Also, comment down below, what is your relationship like with your parents? Do you love them? Do you hate them? Why or why not? Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that, and I'm gonna see y'all next time.